filmed, edited entire music video in a day and a half. The camera is rolling. We just let the thoughts flow. What's up, everyone? Tua here. It's been a while since I've chatted with all of you, so I'm just gonna sit here and update you all on all types of either exciting things that I've either worked on or things that I worked on in the past, and now you're seeing the finished product. All types of cool stuff just here on this nice grassy slope, nice and peaceful. First of all, those of you who remember a little while back, I did a collaboration with Alec and Luther, as well as Jack. We did a collaboration in Florida, and I created some vlogs, we created some vlogs of the whole thing, but we were actually filming a special, like a documentary, you could think of it, more like a bigger movie, and it was just released, it was just the other day released, and I'm sure many of you who are also already subscribed to Alec and Wilderland will have already seen it, but in case you haven't, if you haven't seen the special, you gotta go check it out. Link in the description. You can just pause this video, go check it out, and then return and hear the rest of the update. Now, either you've already seen it, so you're just staying at this video, or you went and watched it, and then you actually went and watched it, actually came back, and if you did so, thank you. Right on, right on. Very awesome. That was, you know, a really fun experience, and also, you know, when you do, like, because of the topic that we are doing the special on, you got to learn a lot, but also, I got to learn a ton, because when you work with other people who use cameras and other creators who film and stuff, it's really interesting to see how they go about filming their videos, because everyone has a different style and different workflow, and, you know, like, some people, they prefer to just, like, get a lot of footage over amount of time and then edit it all at once, and then someone else, they might, like, try to get out as much content as they can each day as quickly. So it's really interesting to see how the different people do their thing. Okay, what else? Oh yes, I recently filmed my first ever music video. So you may remember I had a little starring in the BTFD music video, and if any of you saw that. But my uncles, the same people who made that song and that video, they created another song about McAfee. You know, he's the guy who made the antivirus. He's not a part of that anymore, but that's where a lot of people might know McAfee from. And they did a song about him, and then they wanted to create a music video, and he was like, yeah, he invited us, them to go to where his house is, which is in Tennessee, to go there to film it. And they're like, you know what, they invited me to come down and film it because they have more experience with creating the music and stuff, and the first one they filmed on their iPhone, so they wanted to up the quality a little bit. So I was able to come. I went all the way to the States. It was just for like 2 days. You know, sometimes you get these opportunities. I get these opportunities, and it's only for like 1 or 2 days. And then some people are like, "Why, you were here and you didn't do a meetup?" I would love to just like spend more time in these places and do meetups. But of course, it costs money to stay at places. You have to rent and stuff. And it's just like, okay, well, book your flights just to go for like 2-3 days. And so I don't get a chance to do a bunch of other stuff. But the point is I went and I filmed and edited an entire music video in 1.5 days. So if you watch the music video, even myself watching it, I spot little things like, oh, I could have done that better. I should have redone this shot and like added this or not done this or made the shot better, smoother or whatever. But we had basically 2 days to film and edit this entire music video. So we were trying to get as many shots as possible, and I was spending as much time as I could edit. So it was taking, like, doing my first music video, but also using almost like a vlogger's mentality, because I have experience with doing vlogs and trying to just like get videos out as quickly as possible. That's how I was going about this music video, because we wanted to get it out as quickly as possible. So I feel most of the time if you do a music video, you take your time, it might take days or weeks, or I'm sure there's most music videos take a lot more time. But filmed, edited entire music video in 1.5 days. Actually, you know, creating the creation of the beat to writing the song, producing it, and filming it at an entire music video was, it was done in like not 10 days or like, it was over around 2 weeks. So I heard they said that that's not very common to get that much done that quickly. But you know, opportunities come along and you just gotta make the most of them. So you gotta think of it as they flew me out there to film this. They probably expect that I have some knowledge of filming and also that I know what types of shots I might want to get. So while we were there, if I were to have just been like, oh yeah, let's just like, what shots do you guys want to get? I don't know. Like, I mean, we could do that and I'm not sure if the shot would look good. Like, it could look good. I don't know. Then it doesn't really seem like I know what I'm doing. One of the things I was trying to work on, I heard about this in some tutorials on YouTube about like directing the shoot. So if I would, we'd be filming and trying to get some shots, sometimes I'd see a shot and I have a pretty good idea because I have experience with making a lot of videos. I'd see a clip and I was like, I have a pretty good idea that's gonna look good. So I'd be like, okay, we're gonna do this clip. And it, from everyone else's perspective, may have been strange because I am 16, so I'm like, 16-year-old be like, okay, we gotta get the shot like this. But if I see something, I'm like, I have a pretty good idea that shot's probably gonna look good. You just gotta be like, all right guys, we're gonna get this shot. And it might only take a few minutes. And because I'm also the one editing it, I wanna be happy with the footage that I'm editing. So if you are the filmer and the editor, you have a lot of control. When you go back to edit, you wanna be happy with the clips. You don't wanna just, I don't wanna get back to my computer to edit the footage and be like, I should have said something. Why didn't I say anything? This shot would have looked so much better if I would have said, oh, I think this angle, this direction would have looked better. So that's one of the things. To direct the shots, I was working on that, which I normally don't have to think about. What else did I learn? Oh yes, I got to work on getting different types of shots because in the music video, it's a pretty fast-paced, upbeat, like, fast-moving. So I was getting shots where I'm like, where the camera's like kind of twisting, but then also moving in. And that's a type of shot that I never film because if I'm vlogging and stuff, there's not very often a time where I would get a shot like that. Whereas in this music video, I was getting a good amount. And although I have a lot of time using a camera, it was funny because it felt really strange filming like this because I'm sure if you shoot a lot of music videos, it's just like, becomes second nature, just feels natural getting shots like this and that. Maybe common shots that, common like movement, camera movements that you would use in a music video. But because I never do that, it felt like it was like my first time filming. Not like it was my first time filming, just getting, that's that exact particular movement. So I got to work on some new camera movements, which is always good. Now that I'm thinking back on the shoot, something else that I would probably, it's hard to do this if you've never been to the place where you're going to be filming, but think of more of the shots that I would want to get beforehand and write them down. So my uncles, they're the ones who made the song, who wrote the song and produced it and sung it. They had a list with a few ideas of shots that they thought would look cool, and that was a huge help. But I didn't write down any ideas. I was just like thinking, you know what? Just go and like the way I normally would do with a vlog is I just assess the place and then go from there and just start filming. And usually once I film this, then I'm like, you know what? Maybe this over here would look cool and over there. But because we're only there for about basically a day and a half or near about around 2 days, but everyone slept in the first day. So I'd say a day and a half. It was like, What shots should we get? I don't know. What do you think? And there was a lot of just trying to think of shots on the fly. Whereas if we had a better idea of what clips we wanted to get, that could have made it a bit quicker. So then we could have done more takes of each shot and potentially getting better ones. Those are most of the things that I can remember just right off the top of my head. But overall, amazing experience getting to shoot my first ever music vid. I learned a lot. And you know, it's once in a while opportunities like this come up. I had no plans on shooting a music video, and I had no experience or any idea I'd be doing this, but they're just like, you gotta fly down and film this. And of course, now looking back on the music video, I can see all little things that I could have done better and could have improved on. But the important thing is I finished the music video and it wasn't like a fail or something. It came out good, and now I can watch it over, and if I were to do another one, I can do it in a better job. So, did the best I could, and I can just learn from this experience to help me out if I were to do this again in the future. And also it helps me for my just normal videos. Just experience and practice always helps. It always, you always seem to learn stuff. The more filming and more creating and editing that you do, you just learn new things. It's awesome. It's awesome. It's really great. I'm thirsty. That's just about it for this update. And if you have any questions about what it was like shooting a music video or any specific things you'd like me to go more in depth about, leave it in the comments with hashtag AskAtua, of course. And if there's some really good questions or ones that I have a lot I would like to talk about in the response, then I'll answer them in the future video. And if there's just so many questions I couldn't answer them in just taking up a little bit of a video, I'll do a dedicated video to answering all of the questions, if there are a lot of them. Let's see. That's pretty much it. That's pretty much everything I have to say. There's not too much else. Today's positive quote, concept, thought that I've kind of thought of right now is about how it's actually can be really good to go out of your comfort zone and to do stuff that you don't have a ton of experience with doing. So I do have experience with filming, but I don't have experience with shooting a music video. So one response to this opportunity could have been, oh, I don't do that. I don't really shoot music videos. I have no experience with that. Sorry, I'm not the right person. But because I know the general stuff of filming and stuff, although I had never shot a music video, this is a really great opportunity to, like, break the ice into being comfortable doing a music video. So if I were to ever do another one in the future, I've already done my first one, so I don't have that nervousness of like, oh, this is the first time doing this. So if I were to do it again in the future, I could only feel more comfortable doing it. You'd think my voice is on its way out. It's getting a little rusty. It's been a while since I've done a long talking like this. Remember to keep always doing awesome stuff. See you guys tomorrow, early in the morning. Feels good. It feels super good to be filming and vlogging again.
Alec and Luther, this one's for you guys.
That was a really awesome handstand. Let's see if we can beat it. Ah!